Hello everyone, I'm Candace Adorka for NAVC Spark. Take a trip with me back in time to the 1960s. Lyndon B. Johnson as president, the Vietnam War is underway, and Bonnie Beaver is at the University of Minnesota. She's one of a handful of women in the nation studying veterinary medicine.
There were two in my class, although the second person switched during the time that I was actually in school. And then the class behind me had one, and then they started increasing because that's when the federal law said you cannot discriminate by sex, and so we started to see more women coming into veterinary medicine, although not large numbers for a while.
I spoke with Dr. Beaver in advance of International Women's Day, which celebrates the social, economic, cultural, and political achievements of women around the world. For example, Bonnie Beaver was the first woman to join the faculty of the Texas A&M College of Veterinary Medicine 40 years ago. She's a prolific author and a tireless advocate of animal rights and animal behavior. She's a past president of the Women's Veterinary Medical Association, the Texas Association of Veterinary Medicine, and the AVMA. She's a pioneer, but for her, that was never the goal.
I'm just me, I just do what I do. But I know that for many things that have been part of my career, that they wouldn't have happened if I hadn't just taken the bull by the horns and done them. So I recognize that I have served as a pioneer in many different areas, but that's not what's important to me. What's important to me is that the right things get done.
One of those right things was to increase the visibility of female veterinarians and provide support for the challenges that they face. In that way, women like Dr. Beaver led the charge to get to where we are today, where 55% of veterinarians, almost 90% of veterinary nurses, and 80% of enrolled students in the U.S. are female. She says it's important to celebrate this progress, but it's also important to realize that the goal isn't female domination. It's to foster equality, diversity, and cooperation.
It's better for progress to be able to understand viewpoints that are different than what yours are. We need diversity, we need the different views. So it isn't just a male-female thing, it's a life experience thing as well.
This legacy of women persevering through adversity and assuming positions of leadership continues today. Spark is highlighting three such stories. Dr. Cindy Barnes took on the stress and cost of vet school as a 37-year-old mother of five. And today, she's CEO of her own practice management software company. Captain Kelly Willard took a detour from the traditional veterinary medicine path, and she joined the Army National Guard. She spent a year taking care of more than 100 service dogs and their battlefield injuries before coming home and buying her own practice. And last but not least, licensed veterinary technician Benita Altier. She weathered years of financial and personal hardship before finding success as an entrepreneur and a teacher. Click on their images to watch, then let us know what you think by commenting on social media. And hey, Women's Day or not, we want to hear your personal stories. Email us at spark@navc.com. Thank you for watching.